If you look at the history of the world, we keep repeating ourselves. But whilst the colonizers or the big tech or the dominating whatever are always trying to own everything, there's always communities that resist. And we've been resisting since the day they first came onto our shores, and we continue to resist.
Mozilla is honoring 25 people who are shaping the future of the internet. Here are their stories.
I'm Keoni. I'm the CTO at Te Hiku Media. We are an indigenous Māori non-for-profit. We started out in radio more than 30 years ago. Today we're a tech company building machine learning models to help with the revitalization and promotion of Te Reo Māori, the indigenous language of Aotearoa, and other Pacific languages. Māori are the indigenous people of Aotearoa. I'm Hawaiian. I'm not Māori. My partner is Māori. He's the CEO of the organization. In the indigenous communities, you know, when we're working with technologies and stuff and a revitalization, often we have outsiders coming in, and that's not necessarily like the best approach to moving our communities forward. In 2012, we gathered the elders in the community, and what the elders supported was our move to make our stories available online for people to access. Where we put our data online was really important. If we put it in a platform like YouTube, we actually give the rights of that data, but also the knowledge that's embedded in the stories that we share. We pretty much had to build our own platform from scratch. So we built our own safe space online for our stories. We launched a 24/7 web TV station. This is way before, you know, the big broadcasters in America were doing it. And so since November 2014, we've been uploading the stories in Te Reo Māori of the community, like 5 days a week, every week. Just hundreds of hours of Te Reo Māori and the stories of our people. We're very appreciative that Mozilla and the people who work at Mozilla have recognized our work. How we see the future for the web is important, not for us, but for everyone. It's really important that these minority communities like us are represented. And we just want to absolutely stop the theft of our data, because they've already taken our land and now they're after our data. And we want to stop that, and so that everyone has an equitable future online. Right now, today, we're just one tiny point in time of this whole movement to revitalize, to bring back, to reclaim what was taken from us, to help us ensure we have a place in the future for our people.